This area photograph clearly shows the Four Rushes area. We rejoin the road. I'm struck by a house with a gigantic wooden statue of the head of Buddha. This interpretive sign is about preserving the beauty of the foreshore by maintaining the vegetation. Various bird types in Alfred Cove are identified and shown here. The sign discusses problems of weeds, erosion, and litter, and steps being taken to prevent these things, such as the installation of baffles on the river. There are many different types of wading birds along the river. She oaks, which are non-native, are slowly being removed and replaced with native trees and shrubs to provide nesting areas for birds. We're on the move again, and once again getting away from the river. This sign identifies common weeds found along the route, and it talks about the problems with weeds. Animals found in the area, and note the numbers of poisonous snakes. Some of them are quite deadly. Actually, I've never seen a poisonous snake in Perth, and you're unlikely to see them crawling across these cycleways. Some of the beautiful birds of the area, such as the white-faced heron, or the sacred kingfisher, or fairy wren. We reach Chatterdale Jetty, built for the Melville Park Estate in 1897, was used to bring buyers to Adderdale. It's a popular yachting marker from 1920 until the foreshore was reclaimed and the jetties removed. A sign advertising the Swan Estuary Marine Park, including ecologically important areas of Alfred Cove and Pelican Point. Our next destination is Point Walter, and it's only half a kilometer away. I'm going to catch up with my friends for a barbecue at the public barbecues. Point Walter is quite a large park and wooded area, and it's noted for its very large sand dune, where you can almost cross the Swan River at a low tide. Point Walter was originally named by Captain Stirling, who named it after his brother, I think, in 1827. It's a very popular swimming and recreational area with literally hundreds of young people. It's also got a very nice cafe and restaurant. My friend Mark Pillage, with his girlfriend Rebecca and attendant care worker Brian and his girlfriend Monique. It's on the move again. Now we're headed towards Picton, 2 kilometers to the west. The trip lies through a large park area called Blackwell Reach, and then we follow Blackwell Reach Parade directly along the Swan River to a large public swimming pool. Blackwell Reach is named after a place on the Thames River near Greenwich. It's had many uses, including as a farm, a tavern in the late 1800s, and a tram line ran from the Canning Highway until the 1950s. Today it's a lovely picnic and recreational area. This plaque notes that from 1915 through to the late 1940s, a tram service joined Fremantle through the reserve to Point Walter, and the area was a popular picnic spot. We've reached the end of the reserve and now getting back to roads. We pass by Picton Quarantine Park and reach the public pool. We'll now follow the river along Jared Drive and Riverside Road past another yacht club. Only 6 kilometers left to reach Fremantle. We're forced back on the road, and the cycle trail is marked by a white line to the left and a bit of a sidewalk to the right. We pass the Aquarama. It's safely noted for a lovely restaurant overlooking the river called the Boardwalk. In the far distance, we can see the Fremantle Bridge crossing the Swan River. We pass another lovely restaurant where you can sit out over the Swan River and enjoy fresh fish. This one's called the Red Herring. A small waterfall, now dried up during the summer, overlooking the river. We're almost at the end of the Swan River, and when we reach the bridge, we'll be heading through the city of Fremantle itself to the Rosie O'Grady pub. There are many beautiful old buildings in Fremantle, and I'll just photograph one. I enjoy a Guinness beer. Well, I've covered 35 kilometers in my electric wheelchair. Now I'm going to take the electric train from Fremantle to Cottesloe, home. It's getting late at 20 after 5.